to introduce Reverend Father Hady Mahfouz. Reverend Father Hady Mahfouz became the 12th president of the Holy Spirit University of Kaslik in July 2007. Since taking office, Father Mahfouz has been striving to implement a new vision of education, culture, and community service. As president of USEK, Father Hady Mahfouz has focused his efforts on consolidating pillars of excellence and quality at USEK. Father Mahfouz works towards modernization, innovation, constructive change. He considers diversity as a true source of prosperity. He gives special attention to sustainable development and strives to transform USEK into a carbon neutral university. In 2013, Father Mahfouz was elected as the president of the Conference of Rectors of the Middle East, which brings together 46 Middle Eastern universities and promotes university regional collaboration. He serves on the Global Advisory Council of World Learning. Father Mahfouz came to the presidency after holding the positions of Academic Secretary of the Pontifical Faculty of Theology, Chairperson of the Graduate Program at the Pontifical Faculty of Theology, Director of the University Theological Periodical, and Director at the Financial Aid Office. He was awarded his PhD in Biblical Sciences from the Pontifical Biblical Institute of Rome in 2002. He has lectured and published widely, and he is the author of several books. Father Mahfouz, tafaddal.
Thank you. First of all, I would like to say welcome. I'm so happy to have you here at the university on our campus. It's not the first time that we're welcoming a group of the Maronite Academy, and it's really a privilege and honor for our university to have you here as groups of youth, of Maronite youth from all over the world. I would like also to greet Father Sharbel Shaheen, who is the head of our monastery and parish in Beirut, in Ashrafiyye, in downtown practically. And he's here because he has parishioners of his old parish in Mexico, in Puebla. And he's here to greet them. Okay. Let me start by why you're here. I didn't prepare like a lecture. I would wait for your questions and our conversation. Please prepare some nice questions. I would like just to answer your questions, to know what is your background. I knew that you're coming from about 20 countries, and that's very nice. But I will start with one point, the point of identity. You're here because there is a common identity, our Maronite identity. So you have like a heritage in you that you're bearing in you, because your parents or your belonging is from the Maronite heritage. And I would go to that one. I think what I heard that many of you have their first visit to Lebanon, yes? Or all of you? Few for the first time. So I supposedly, you know what's Holy Valley, you know what's Annaya, you know the saints, Saint Sharbel, Rafka, Hardini, and Blessed Stefan. You know, and I think that's what gives shape to our identity, to our Maronite identity, especially our belonging to a spiritual heritage, and for sure to a social, cultural heritage also. So you're discovering Lebanon, you're living in in countries abroad, but you're discovering Lebanon more and more now, and discovering the spiritual heritage, the social and cultural heritage also. That means you're discovering also the identity you have, even if you are living in other countries abroad. And I'm insisting on identity, and you will understand why I'm insisting on identity and repeating the same words, just to let you know that when you will go to the Holy Valley, when you will go to Annaya, to the sanctuaries of our saints, and when you will discover Lebanon more, you will understand much more about your identity, your common identity. Many of you don't know each other, you know, because if you're coming from Brazil, from United States, from Canada, from Latin America, or from Sweden, or Europe, or Australia, or whatever, I'm pretty sure you don't know each other well. And now you're discovering each other's, and you can say that there is something in common we can build upon. So when we say identity, I made this introduction to go to the university. And maybe you will say now, why identity and university? Because this university belongs to the Lebanese Maronite order. It is the order of the saints. And the saints, you know, Sharber, Rafka Hardini, Blessed Stefan, all are from this order. And this order was named before and till now in some places the Rahbani al-Baladiyye, so the Baladite, Baladite is from Balad, from nation, order, okay? That means it's with Lebanese, it's Lebanese. So formed by Lebanese, because we are almost all Lebanese in our order. And because it has had always the Lebanese as main concern. So you can find monasteries of the Lebanese Maronite order over all Lebanon, everywhere, in all parts of Lebanon, in the Bekaa, in the extreme north, in extreme south, in Mount Lebanon, and in many places in Lebanon, because this order followed Lebanese everywhere, followed Maronites everywhere, and even in the diaspora, in many places abroad, so in Sydney, in Australia, in Abidjan, in Dakar, in Brazil, in Argentina, in Mexico, in Venezuela, in Canada, in London, in Paris, in Rome, Cyprus, and that's it, I think. Holy Land, yeah. And so Lebanese, and it is among the few orders, maybe the unique order in the world, I don't know, but let me say few orders, among few orders in the world, which has the name of the country, of the nation, inside the name of the order, because we have Lebanese Maronite order. Lebanon is inside the name of the order. So you can imagine how much, and Maronite, the identity also, in the name of the order. So you can tell from the name the concern of this order. And this order has many fields it is working in, like hospitals, like university, higher education in schools, parishes. And it was known especially for having lands and doing agricultural work. It reflects the philosophy of being attached to the land, to the heritage, and that's a way of preserving the identity. And this order founded the university. So our university stems from a long tradition of higher education. When we say the Lebanese Maronite Order, we think of the Holy Valley, we think of Qashaya Monastery. The Qashaya Monastery maybe you know it, the Qashaya, no? You will go there. So Qashaya Monastery has the first printing press in the Middle East. In 1610, the 17th century, this monastery brought to the Middle East the first printing press, the first one, yeah, in the Middle East. And the first printed book is here in the university. And so 1610, you will see like a commemoration there in the museum at the monastery. You will see the like a commemoration of this printing press there. So you can tell that this education and higher education tradition is in the Lebanese Maronite order from its beginning on. And but then the higher education in the order was in many places, especially in theology and philosophy. Sometimes after the before the World War One, two, excuse me, in 1938, the order decided to found this campus, and then because of the war, they started in 1947 to build the buildings here, the campus here, and the first class was 1949-50, and then. They started with theology and philosophy. And being Lebanese, the first language at that time was French. We started to be French-speaking university, and we remained with the French system and the French language until the 2000. So begin with the beginning of the 21st century, we adopted the American credit system, okay? American credit system. And year after year, we introduced the English language, and now we have many curricula, so many programs, totally in English. And this year, we adopted the new bylaws of the university to fit the American accreditation criteria. To have new governance, new structure at the university, and to have a board of trustees that would be a historical one. We just finished having our board of trustees, and we'll have soon the first its first meeting, and that will be really historical for our university. That means also more and more introducing English in the university. And that's due for sure to also the shift of the linguistic landscape of Lebanon. You know, Lebanon is changing a little bit towards also in the schools towards English, while preserving our French-speaking mark in the areas where it should be also. So this is our university. The Holy Spirit University of Kaslik, which is USEK. USEK stands for Université Saint-Esprit de Kaslik, USEK. And now we have faculties. I will start like I know them in the buildings. So law school, philosophy and humanities, letters, fine arts and architecture, music, theology, theology, history, business and commercial sciences faculty, agricultural faculty, science, engineering, medical school, and the hospital, the Maronite Hospital, Our Lady of Help Hospital in Jbel is affiliated to our faculty of medicine, the medical school. And because it belongs also to our order, and what we have also as schools, the Political Science Institute, because it's giving now the online courses on political issues in the Middle East, and many from all over the world are subscribed in these courses. And let me add also that that we are very open to internationalization. We were last year the first university from outside Americas in an internationalization lab in the ACE. The ACE stands for American Council on Education, which gathers about 2,000, maybe much more. We are yearly about 2,000 people gathered in Washington or elsewhere in the U.S., but we were the first university from outside Americas to partake in that lab, and we're really proud of. And maybe weekly, we have someone or many of our university in a part of the world, just because we're very interested in internationalization. That means also not only traveling, but also being open to good practices, to international practices in higher education. That means also accreditation, that means also ranking, that means also being like universities everywhere. And that's a main concern for us to stay at the level of the best universities in the world. According to our capacities here, what we have in funds, in human resources, in many other things which can influence directly our life inside the university. And in the university, when you say university, I liked a lot what Mr. Frame said about when he was presenting me, that our university welcomes all classes and helps all classes access higher education. That pleased me a lot, because really we are doing so. This year we reached a very, very high amount of financial aid to many of our students. I will not say the amount, but I will say that more than half of the students here have financial aid, either through scholarships or through case study financially. Needy people, and you can be sure that we banned somehow, you know what is wasta? You know what's wasta? Yes, somehow we banned it. It's a recommendation. Wasta is a bad word of recommendation. Wasta. Okay. So the bad side, it's very known in the Middle East and in Lebanon, wasta. Okay. What? Connection? Okay, a connection. A connection. Okay, that's it. So it's because for financial aid, we have six social workers, and the students, without any wasta, comes into the office and just ask for help, saying, that's my case. A social worker welcomes him or her and study the case, and if necessary, the social worker meets also the parents, the family, and can investigate more. And then a file is filled, an application is filled, and thoroughly studied. And then a committee decides upon the amount to be allocated to this person, to this student. And we're very happy. We're very proud to do such things. We're very happy because it's part of our mission here at the university. And we're very happy because this budget allocated to to the needy students is going really to the needy ones, not to the recommended ones. Okay? This was a little bit my presentation about what is the university. The university, you can tell from the website how open it is, how the practices. Many, I will not list now many points, but in many points we were pioneering in Lebanon. For example, because now I'm remembering something that we just launched the LTEC, so Learning and Teaching Excellence Center, and that's a premier in Lebanon. No one till now has such a center. We did it because it's very needed in Lebanon, and now we were the first university also to launch a program of forming teachers in universities, because you can have a diploma, in teaching. Myself, I did two sessions this year, one online and one here with Texas Austin University, and another one was Oklahoma University online. I did it myself, and other 90 teachers of our university did such sessions just to be updated on the new ways of teaching in higher education. In that session of Texas Austin University, I was myself with other four or five deans for 2 weeks from 9 till 5 p.m. a little bit, because I was so impressed by the Maronite Academy students, and I said I would do like them for 2 weeks following a session. So you're a good example for us. So now I'm awaiting for your questions. Please, you can ask whatever you wish. You can ask if you have problems in English, you can ask in Spanish, in French, in Italian. In Spanish, you can ask.
Short questions.
No podré hablar muy bien en español, pero podré preguntar a Padre Sharbel Shaheen para ayudar. Para ayudar a contestar. Okay. خليه يطلع لهون خليه او يقعد هون مثل ما بده ايه لك يزيح هون إيه بس لحظه لانه because you know him Mr. Michel Eddy, former minister, and he helps the Maronite identity in many ways. He helps the Maronite identity in many ways, and especially in the Maronite Academy. You know that he's the head of the Maronite Academy. So he's the one who put everything together so that you can be able to come here with the nice stuff he has, especially with Hiyam, his family. So it's an opportunity to thank him for all what he has been doing for the Maronite identity in many regards, and especially now in the Maronite Academy. So thank you, Mr. Your Excellency, Mr. Michel Eddy, former minister, in many cabinets, And it's an opportunity also to thank all the staff of the Maronite Academy, but especially Hiyam Bustani, a great person in our community. And I know you will be very sad if I don't thank Father Hady Mahfouz, because he's working with you. I didn't want to thank him because I don't like him at all, but thank you, Hady. Okay.
Hello, Stephanie from Canada. So I know you mentioned that you try to avoid the WASTA for the university, but I just wanted to ask, do you have any initiatives for students to prepare them for the industry? And because everyone says, oh, you can only get a job if you have a WASTA. Do you have like an internship program that could help prepare students for the real world?
For sure, and we have the careers office, which takes care of also the future of our students. We have the alumni office with the careers office, which are working hard in this regard. And be sure that the university can help a lot changing the society. But the society is there, and one should or must interact with the society. And I'm not pessimistic on my view on Lebanon, on our society, not at all. Because every society in the world has its own weaknesses and has its own problems. We have ours for sure, and the task of each citizen and of each institution, like universities, schools, Maronite Academy, eminent personalities in the society, is to work to enhance the life of each citizen and of the society. So let's always be positive and act for the common good, so for the good of society, for the single person and the society as a collective person.
Any other question?
Maximiliano from Argentina. I speak English, but I prefer to do in Spanish the question.
Yes,
so
yes,
Father, help
me.
Do
it in Spanish.
Quería saber si dentro de la Facultad de Teología de la Universidad, ¿cuál sería la especialización de la Facultad de Teología? Digo, si hay algo especialmente relacionado con la Iglesia Maronita o si hay algo general en cuanto a lo teológico.
Es una pontificia Facultad de Teología. La única del Medio Oriente, so es obligatorio en esta facultad de tener el sistema del Vaticano. Es la teología como en todo el mundo. No tenemos puede ser una o uno o dos cursos para el Medio Oriente, para el patrimonio teológico maronita o del Medio Oriente, pero es general como en todo el mundo.
Thanks. We need translation.
He asked about the theology, if in the Faculty of Theology, if it's the theology of the Maronites only. I answered that it's a unique pontifical faculty of theology in the Middle East, and that means when you are pontifical, you should follow the curriculum of the Vatican, because it's a diploma delivered on behalf of the Vatican, on behalf of the Holy Father. So it's a general the general curriculum of theology, but we have for sure maybe one or two or three courses specifically about Maronites or the Middle East. Eastern churches. Yes. Es una ocasión para practicar mi español.
Hi, I'm Charbel from Venezuela. I'm asking Spanish.
Okay.
Or in Arabic, you can do it Arabic, in Arabic.
Arabic, yalla.
أبونا كيف تعملوا بالكذا religions؟ إنه مش الكاثوليك بإنه بالجامعة مش إنه بيدرسوا بس الكاثوليك إنه كيف تعملوا تا؟
لا هي just.
¿Cómo hacen para tratar con las diferentes religiones? ¿Cómo participan en la?
Sí, I would answer in English. Okay, he asked, what we do with the many religions we have inside the university. That was your question, yes?
Yes.
Okay. You can sit if you wish. And, okay. You know, our religion is the Catholic faith. And because the Maronites are typically Catholic, you know. And in our faith, or our faith is in its essence, so its real truth is to be open to everyone, to be open to every human being without any discrimination, and to take care of all the human being. So it's a motto in the Catholic Church to take care of all human being, so every human being, without any discrimination, and all the human being, so the human being in his or her dimensions, all dimensions, among which you have the spiritual dimension. So we are open to every denomination, every religious denomination, without any discrimination. But we're Catholic, so we have our identity, and we show very clearly this identity. And every student should have a course of 3 credits on religious education, which is mainly about Catholic, which can be taken as cultural knowledge, you know? Even if you are not from a religion, you can have some knowledge about. And this is our way of dealing with. But, you know, because we are in a region with a very, very big majority of Christians here in the region, the big majority of our students are reflects this situation. Okay, it's clear? Okay, so it's open to everyone without any discrimination, but we have our identity, which we show with big pride.
Please, short questions. Very short questions.
Okay, I'll make it short. I'm Tony from Canada. So you said this university is pioneering in many ways. It was one of the first to give out financial action. Now, do you think that in time this will cause a ripple effect in Lebanon and establish a national board that helps give out aid to all students in Lebanon who can't afford higher education? Like other countries have adopted, their own institutes help all students. You have one for just this university. But there are many students in Lebanon who cannot afford education. You think in time you can establish a national board that helps students on a case-by-case basis, objectively, that goes around the typical WASTA? You think that's going to happen eventually, or do we have a long way to go to reach that point?
Okay. First of all, we have this year, we were about maybe 8,300, if I'm not mistaken, students. And I said more than half of them, so at least 4,600 or 700, something like that, had somehow scholarships, in either financial aids or for excellence in learning, you're asking about giving opportunity to all students of Lebanon.
Yes.
Okay, that's an issue which should be dealt with in a national level, at a national level. It's not inside the order. I'm talking about our order, our university. We feel that our mission is to help people coming to us, because we should of maintaining, preserving the good level of education, of higher education. I talked about, we have the openness, the big openness, the internationalization, the accreditation, all international practices. You can, if you stay some months, if you want, you're welcome. You can see the practices, the international practices inside our university. And there is something I didn't talk about. Fadi knows well because he's very close also to the library staff. In our library, we have something very unique. We have a unique lab of preservation and reparation and conservation of old books and manuscripts in Lebanon. We are unique in what we have there. And now we are renewing all the library. The ones who know our library will be surprised in Christmas what they will with what they will see in Christmas in our library. We'll have a completely like a new library, and we're doing all that to fit the accreditation criteria for libraries. So everything is moving internationally. That means a lot of funds. At the same time, we're very concerned to enable the students, our students, to complete their studies. That means also a lot of funds.
The last question.
Thank you, Abuna. My name is Jessica from Canada. As I've heard, like, you're trying to get the university to get recognized internationally. I know a lot of students that want to attend the university from outside of Lebanon, but they feel as though if they take any credits, let's say they go into professional schools, if they go back, then ma bi'atarfu fiha lalshahada. And like, what are the initiatives that are done to make it happen and to facilitate that transfer?
Sure, we have a very good service in students exchange in the International Affairs Office. You can be in touch with through email, through the internet, through the website, and they can establish a contact with the university of origin, and they can study with the faculty. For example, if you are in business faculty, maybe, I don't know, they can ask our business of faculty to be in touch with the universities there, and they establish some agreement to enable you to have your credits recognized by them also.
So, sorry, just to ask that question, if it's a professional school and they want to go back and practice, let's say in the country of origin, are there any like student-run clubs or any affiliations between the universities?
Yeah, for sure. That's what I said. You can see the list of our partners on our website. If your university of origin does not appear in that list, you can ask our university to be in touch with. Oh yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
I meant it. I know when you're coming from abroad, you can't imagine what we have in Lebanon, and how open we are. I'm a little bit bragging now our work, but it's a reality. It's not only words. The last question.
Hello, Stephanie from Canada again.
Again, Canada.
I just want to know, are there any initiatives to encourage women in engineering? Because there's not any women that, like, they feel intimidated to go into programs at, like, that technical, especially in this country, and they feel like it's a bad stereotype. And are there any initiatives taken to encourage them and introduce them to, like, programming?
To encourage whom?
Women. Yeah.
You know, I feel, you know, we have about more than 55% women at the university.
But that doesn't mean they're in engineering.
Oh yeah. No, no. The majority in engineering are women. Let me add something. You know, from outside, I will be sure. I will make a call just to be sure of. No. Just to be sure. But I'm. No, for sure. But at the graduation, for sure. But engineering also. But let me add something. Just don't have. Maybe, because. Hello, Pascal. لك عم بيسألوني هالجي من برا. ليش عدد ال يعني البنات تجاه الشباب الانجنييرين؟ 5 دقايق. بعت لي واتساب عشان ما تلفن ولدش. بس بقى في 5 دقايق أقل بقى جملية. لأنه خلصت المحاضرة معهم. يلا. أكتر. بس let me add this last thought. It's very important. I think the media give about Lebanon an idea which does not fit well with the reality. Okay? Because I understood very well your question. Because you have the background maybe that women in Lebanon are like put aside. No? Not that far. Okay. Because no, for many who come to Lebanon, they have such an idea. At least not here in our university and our in our here ambiance.
I think no more questions.
Okay.
We have a coffee break for 10 minutes.
Let her ask the last question.
So generous.
Last question. Really, last question. I know time is pressing, but...
I'm Miriam from Massachusetts, and my question is... Well, first of all, I want to say that... Please,
I'm not hearing. Please.
First of all, I want to say that I'm really impressed that you guys have a program in which you provide financial aid to people who need it. I think that's very critical in Lebanon, and I would hope that other colleges would consider doing that and implementing that in their program as well. My family left Lebanon for the purpose of education, and I think that's something that can definitely bring people back and prevent people from leaving. So I would hope that in the near future, other colleges also consider doing that and that they're working on it. So my question is, do you believe that other colleges are and universities are interested in providing students with financial aid and getting people who don't have the means to have education to do so?
It depends on the colleges, yes. There are some working also well in this field, but it depends on colleges. But I can add a last comment, we are the best. That's, if you don't know the word, that's called humility.
Coffee break for 10 minutes. Only 10 minutes.
Hey, أكيد.
الله عليك إذا مش عارف شو بدك تحكي وهيك. حضر شو؟
شو؟